Distant shores rejoice. Clouds and thick darkness surround him. Righteousness and justice are the foundation of his throne. Fire goes before him and consumes his foes on every side. His lightning lights up the world. The earth sees and trembles. The mountains melt like wax before the Lord. Before the Lord of all the earth, the heavens proclaim his righteousness, and all people
will see his glory. We're going to see the glory of the Lord that you're riding. Are you ready? We're about to see the glory of the Lord from your nation. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. We want you to pray. Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah.
let it rain.
Get this off. We got one more. My mouth.
Let it rain.
I love this song. Let's worship him. I love this. I love this song.
We've got the Lord. Jesus is living in you and me. I hope that Jeremy can.
I can see what is raging at my feet. I can feel the breath of those surrounding me. I can hear the sound of nations rising up. We will not be overtaken. We will not be overcome. I can walk down this dark and painful road. I can face every fear of the unknown. I can hear all God's children singing out. We will not be overtaken. We will not be overcome.
Yes, get ready.
The same power that rose Jesus from the grave.
Yeah.
The same power that commanded death to wait.
Tune in to Dawn's Heartfelt Corner. I'm telling you, saints, we are almost there. You know, I wasn't planning on doing a video today. You know, President Donald Trump was just on live talking about the coronavirus. Him and Mike Pence may still be on, but they were on. And so I was listening to what the president was saying. You know, those reporters were coming at him, you know, because he shook hands, you know, and he touched the mic. I mean, they want to come at him with everything, you know. But, you know, God's involved in this. We're going to pray for the president, too, because this thing is spreading. I'm telling you, we've got a lot to talk about. A biological weapon, I'm telling you, it was formed with China and Bill Gates and the New World Order, because I'm telling you right now, we're getting ready to see a change. They don't want you to know what's getting ready to happen. We're getting ready to see a huge change. All right. We're going to put that full armor on in a minute. I've got to read a word. I like this word. I'm going to read a courage word from Prophet Russ. And then I'm going to read you this. I don't know if you've got that email. Billy Graham is calling all of us to pray for our National Day of Prayer tomorrow. And I'm going to read that to you. Prophet Russ said this. The Father says today's day grounded in my word. It is true that the prophets speak contrary to one another at times. One will prophesy a day of gloom and darkness, and another will prophesy the morning spread on the mountains. According to where your affections lie, they're both right. Set your affections on me, says the Father, and you will never be shaken. That's right. We've got to look to God, saints. We got to look to the Lord. And you know, remember I said we got to be built on a solid rock, Christ Jesus. Because when the flood waters come on, what's going to happen if we're not? We're going to collapse. Maybe I should. Where's my Bible? Hold on a second. Maybe we need to read it. You know, maybe we need to read it. Seriously, you know. We don't hear enough of God's word. So we've got to keep repeating it over and over again. We in the church, we pull up those scriptures and we just read what we want to read, right? We don't read the truth. We live in this fantasy world and we think nothing's ever going to change. Now, people are starting to wake up. Not everyone, but there are Christians that are now waking up because they're starting to see what's going on, all right? There's going to be more waking up in the days ahead because God is looking for a strong body of believers because he needs more of you and I. He said the harvest is planted, but the workers are few. He needs you and I to go out there and do the work that he's called us to do because, yes, Jesus is coming back. I don't know when. Nobody knows. One day is like 1,000 years. 1,000 years are like one day to the Lord, but he is coming back. All right. He will return to earth. Let me see if I can find it here. I told you, I don't know where everything's at. But, you know, I'm learning more where open my mouth and just speak it. That's what I believe the Holy Ghost is going to have you and I doing in this last day. Where is that story? I know it's in Matthew. About being buried. Wow. I always forget. It's in Matthew, what is this? 7. Starting verse 24. See, this is why it's so important. Remember that picture I have put up with President Donald Trump? The flood war is coming in. The desk is there, and then the desk is gone. So when you know the word of God, and you're planted on the rock, and you're reading God's word, what's coming out of your mouth? The word of God. If you are not reading scripture, there's nothing coming out, saints. You're not built on Jesus. So when things happen, you're not going to know what to do. And there's going to be many that are going to be lost. We're getting ready to see a great falling away. We talked about that before. All right. We've seen some of it already in the churches, but there's coming more. I mean, people are literally going to go their own way. They're going to go where their itchy ears want to go. They're going to run. And then there'll be those that want to hear what God has to say. And I believe God will direct you. So, Father, we pray for that right now. There is a great falling away that's getting ready to happen, Lord. There are those that love you, Lord, and maybe they just don't know. They're just been sitting in these lukewarm churches, Lord, and listening to these pastors, Lord, that are pulling out scriptures but not speaking the true word. Lord, I pray, oh God, that you would direct them in the days ahead, that you would show them where they're to listen to, Lord. And we just believe that right now. I pray for them. I lift up those ones that are going to be scattered, Lord, that you would put them where they need to be, Lord, and protect them and watch over them, Lord, in Jesus' name. Because there's a lot that's getting ready to happen. Okay, so let me read this. Matthew 7, verse 24. Therefore, everyone who hears these words of mine and puts them in to practice is like a wise man who built his house on the rock. 25, the rain came down, the streams rose, and the winds blew and beat against that house. Yet it did not fall because it had its foundations on the rock. But everyone who hears these words of mine and does not put them into practice, like a foolish man who built his house on sand. The rain came down, the streams rose, and the winds blew and beat against that house, and it fell with a great crash. See, if we are not grounded on the word of God, we don't have that relationship with Jesus. When those floodwaters come in, which we're getting ready to see, we're not going to be able to make it. We're going to collapse. And there's going to be a lot of Christians that are going to be lost. They're not going to know what's going on. But now is the time. If you're backslidden from the Lord, you need to go to God. I'm serious. Get in your prayer closet. Say, God, help me. Put me back on track where I need to be. I need you, Lord. I see the world changing, Lord. Help me, Lord. Forgive me, Lord. I haven't been following you. Put me back where I need to be in Jesus' name. Just go to God. He hears you. A little later, we'll pray for those that don't know the Lord. Maybe you're listening and you've been listening and you don't know the Lord. You know, you mock and you persecute, but now you're starting to see the light. You're saying, hey, wait, something's going on. You know, I just want to stop and say this. You know, we're going to talk about this coronavirus in a minute. You know, what's going on with this toilet paper and all these sanitary products. I've got videos coming up, saints. I got videos that I just took yesterday. I was in the parking lot by the BJ's Costco, like where I live, you know, and I went filming through the parking lot, and it was so crowded. Everybody was there. I mean, same with the LEDs. Daniel's saw them too. I mean, these people are buying everything out. Okay. And so you can't even get your normal needs because, you know, everyone's buying, they're panicking. And the Lord showed me something too. When one person does it, what happens? Everyone just does it. And that's going to be what's going to happen last days. Remember, if someone is preaching here, we'd be careful not to go here, go there. All right. Because they're going to say, Jesus over here or Jesus over there. We've got to hear what the Holy Spirit is saying. We've got to be directed by Him in these last days. So, Father, we pray for that right now, that we will not be deceived. And that Holy Spirit, that you will speak to our hearts and direct and guide us there. We will be led by your Spirit, not be led by our head, not be led by fear. Because, yes, our world's going to panic and people are going to get fearful, Lord. So we don't want to be led by our emotions, Lord, but we want to be led by your Spirit. Help us to remain calm, Lord, because perfect love drives out fear. We come against that spirit of fear, that spirit of worry right now in Jesus' name. We just come against that right now. Our hope and trust is in you, Lord. Amen, amen. We've got a lot to talk about. Let me read this prayer real quick by Billy Graham. I like this. He's calling all of us because the president has declared tomorrow, Sunday, March 15th, to be a national day of prayer. He reminded the entire country that throughout its history, the United States has looked to God for strength and protection in times like these. I'm thankful, he says, to President Trump for recognizing the power of prayer and showing faith in the Lord to intervene on our behalf. With so much uncertainty surrounding the coronavirus at home and around the world, people are afraid. Now is the time for Christians to be strong and courageous, knowing that the Almighty God is with us. As His Word instructs, we're to cast our cares upon Him because He cares for us. 1 Peter 5:7. We need to pray for those who are sick and their families, for those who are living in fear and anxiousness, for the professionals who are providing medical care, for those working on treatments and vaccine for COVID-19, and for our leaders to act with wisdom and courage as they make vital decisions that impact each of our lives. Please also lift up the president and our nation's coronavirus task force, headed by Vice President Mike Pence, in prayer as they work closely and diligently with the myriad of issues related to this pandemic. Some churches, he says, are not meeting in person for worship this Sunday to avoid possibly spreading the virus. But that doesn't prevent us as the body of Christ from coming for the Lord. Kneeling in prayer and pouring our hearts out to Him, let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace that we may obtain mercy and find grace out in time of need. Hebrews 4:16. I ask that you contact your friends and family. So if you know of anyone, pass on. Say, tomorrow we need to pray. And if you can pass here and there, it's important things that we do. I have this on, I have it on a separate video. You know, if you're not a subscriber on YouTube, go over there now. You know, I don't place as many on Facebook. I don't even know where I'm going to be, actually. I don't know what God's going to do. I leave it in the Lord's hands. But I have on there, saints, it's so important now that we repent as a nation, and we do. It's time we repent. We have not turned to God, because I'm going to tell you right now, things are majorly going to change, okay? And we cannot act out of fear, all right? And they're bringing this thing in slowly because the money's going to change. And on one of those videos, go listen, because, you know, I'm going to just say something to you. I'm not telling you to run to your bank and go get your money, okay? There are those telling you, take out all your money. I don't believe that, okay? I had a check yesterday, and I kept hearing the Holy Spirit tell me to go cash it so I had some money on hand. And I'm going to say that to you. I'm not telling you to get all your money out of the bank, okay? So don't say I said that, because I'm not telling you to do that, okay? I don't believe the whole thing's going down right this second. I told you, I believe, this is my opinion, we're going to see a decline in the economy, okay, before we see a major crash, all right? I believe the Holy Spirit, because it kept coming to me, so I went and cash checked so I had some money on hand, because something may happen where they have to close the bank for a little while. You know, they're closing schools, they're closing stores, but we don't need to panic, okay? We just need our basic needs, you know, that's it. All right. God can take the little bit that you have and I have multiplied. We don't need to worry, rush to the store, buy all the paper towels, buy all the toilet paper, go nuts. I even felt some people. I'll let you go look at it. You know, one, they had their gloves on, they had their mask on. One said, I didn't argue with him. I was very polite. You know, I told him Jesus will put it. He said he didn't believe, he was an unbeliever. And I see people getting all this water, you know, but that was their normal, you know, I drink a lot of water, so, but, you know, and then one was having their mask and their gloves and they didn't want to talk, so, but you know what, and I got to tell you something about that. Oh, buddy, I got to share this with you in a minute, and this is going to bring you encouragement, saints. God said something to me today because I asked him a question about this coronavirus. You know, we're going to have more virus, and that's what we're going to talk about today. We're going to talk about something that's going to be worse than the coronavirus. It's going to be more deadly, that God said. It's going to get people right on the spot, okay? Now, I'm praying we're out of here before those, you know, those plagues that God talks about, you know. But, and I believe this is a forerunner of this coronavirus, because more is coming, okay? We're going to see more. And so we have to learn to just rest in God, my answer. Because I told you, we're going to have a lot of disasters. So we have to stay calm and know that God's in control. Because if we don't, we're going to react to every little thing. Because there's going to be a lot of things that are going to happen. All right. So let me finish this. I said, our world's about to change. There is no fear when Jesus, our Lord, is in control. Fear not, says the Lord. God is in control and he will watch over you and me if we walk closely with the Lord. Obeying him in spirit and truth, Jesus promises you and I never to leave us nor forsake us. Trust him today. God is there, saints, when the whole world walks out on you. Remember, you have a friend who sticks closer than a brother. Amen. His name is Jesus. Amen. Yahweh. God to God is prayer. Go to God in prayer today. The Lord is waiting for you and he loves you. Amen. All right, so God is there. We don't need to live our lives in fear, but we do need to obey him and walk with the Lord. All right, let's put that full armor on. Remember, I said every day, I tell Dan, you got to put that full armor. I do it before, you know, I started the morning prayer. It's hard, saints. I'm going to let you know, I don't sleep good. I'm up every hour, 2 hours. I'm up and down, up and down. I think last night I was up at 4 hours. I mean, four times last night. So, and then there's times I may do the early prayer. Like I'll get up at 1:30 in the morning and I'll stay up and then I'll do the prayer and I'll do some other stuff. And I don't lay back down until 7:30. I may lay down for an hour and a half. I mean, I'm back up again. All right. And the Holy Spirit is telling me, and I'm telling you this too, that we need to be led by the Spirit of God in these last days. I know I have to, because there were things that, you know, sometimes we all like that. We do things that God doesn't want us doing. Like, you know, I don't go in the gym anymore. I stopped doing that. You know, I'll take a walk. But Dan gets mad and he worries about me, you know, because I'll walk down the road, you know, and I'm preaching. I'm bold. You know, that's me. All right. I love the Lord, so I'm on fire, wanting to warn people. In fact, that was where the gas station was. I was on the sidewalk, you know, and I'm warning the people while they're pumping up gas, getting gas, you know. And this one lady, she had a cross thing on her car, and she was listening, you know. So, but Daniel worries because he thinks I'm getting too close to the street, you know. And I told him, you know, the Holy Spirit is really talking to me. Pray for me, saints. No, it's not just me. This is for you. I'm telling you right now, God's teaching me to mind my own business. And yes, you've been listening to Daniel because, hey, I'm going to tell you, I've said this before. When Daniel first got married, I wouldn't listen to him at all. I mean, he thought he married a military sergeant, you know, but I'm seeing God's working. He's still changing me. He's still changing you, you know. Daniel would tell me something. I wouldn't listen to him. But now when he'll say something to me, I'll go in the bathroom and God will show me that was wrong. You shouldn't have done that. And then I'll say, honey, I was wrong. I shouldn't have. And then I've told you, Daniel, he blows up. He gets all upset. And I tell him, I said, honey, you need to calm down. You need to talk to me. You know, it's kind of like your children, you know. If you don't do it in love and you just tell them, don't do this, and just real mean about it, what's going to happen? They're going to do it anyway, right? They're going to rebel. So I told Daniel, talk to me nice, calmly. Be sensitive, you know. I try to explain that to him because I'll listen to him more if he'll just talk to me nice and calm, you know. So God's showing me that. And I said, God, you're amazing, you know, because, you know, and hopefully Daniel will speak soon, you know. But he just, you know, I mean, I've seen God work. He is so amazing. God is amazing. You know, maybe you're going through that situation. You know, and you're trying to change that husband or wife. Don't change him. Let God change him. God sees what's going on. None of us are perfect. We're all changing from glory to glory. You know, Daniel, God's told me this before. Daniel loves me unconditionally, and I'm like his anchor. So we're opposites attract. God has him and I together for a reason, you know. So whether or not you think you're with that person for a reason, you need to trust God. God knows exactly what to do. We think we know more than God, all right? And what happens, we'll push open doors and we'll make a mess out of things. So we've got to stay put where God has us and let God change us. Sometimes he allows, whether it be your job, wherever you go, those people to irritate you or to upset you because he wants to change you, all right? I told you, years ago when Daniel and I first got married, I said, God, if you don't change Daniel, this is when I could drive. I said, dang it, God, if you don't change Daniel, I'm leaving him. And God said, I'm not worried about changing Daniel. I'm worried about changing you. See, we got to quit worrying about that other person. We got to worry about ourselves and ask God, Lord, change us. So, Lord, we just pray right now, Lord, that you would change all of us and make us more like you and not worry what that other person is doing, Lord. We need to just worry about ourselves and that we do what's right. Because we're all going to stand before you on Judgment Day. And you're going to say, what did you do? So, Lord, we want to walk faithfully before you and do what you're asking us to do today. In Jesus' name. So stop worrying about your wife, your husband. You just do what you're supposed to do. That's the word for some of you today. And that's for me, too. I'm not just talking to you. So let's put that full arm. Set the guard watch over your mouth. Hey, especially if you're a teacher, you're a preacher, you know, we're called to talk, okay? I know I'm a talker. I'm a woman. That's a woman. We love to talk. So, you know, in my brain injury, sometimes I'll say things and I think. So pray for me. I need your prayer, you know, because that's what a protector, God's going to protect me. He knows exactly what's happening. So let's put the guard, watch our mouth. Psalm 141:3-4. Verse 3, set a guard, Lord, over my mouth. Keep watch over the door of my lips. Do not let my heart incline to any evil, to busy myself with wicked deeds, in company with men who work iniquity, and let me not eat their delicacies. All right, so we have to watch our words, and we've got to be few. We've got to mind our own business, saints. You know, we've And that goes for me too, you know. When I went filmed, it wasn't protesting. Now, I don't believe in us getting involved in protesting. Now, if it was getting really wild, no, I wouldn't be there. I just wanted to show you what we're seeing, okay? But no, I don't feel God wants me doing that. He wants us to mind our own business and not worry what others are doing. You know, again, I smell drugs here in this apartment. It upsets me, but I just leave it in the Lord's hand. Because I'm believing God's going to open the door. Maybe you're going through something in your apartment. We have to trust God. And you got to trust Him, saints. We all got to trust God in these last days. So let's put that full armor on. Ephesians 6, 10 through 20. Verse 10. Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and the power of His might. Put on the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. Verse 12. For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this age, against spiritual hosts of wickedness in the heavenly places. Verse 13. Therefore, take up the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand. Verse 14. Stand therefore, having girded your waist with truth, having put on the breastplate of righteousness. Verse 15, having shod your feet with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Verse 16, above all, taking the shield of faith, which you will be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked one. Verse 17, take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit. Being watchful this end with all perseverance and supplication for all the saints. Verse 19, and for me that utterance may be given to me, that I may open my mouth boldly. See, we've got to open our mouth boldly and speak God's word to make known the mystery of the gospel. Verse 20, for which I'm an ambassador in chains, in it I may speak boldly as I ought to speak. So we've got to open our mouths and we've got to speak boldly. Now, like I said, make sure you put that full armor on every day. Put it on your door so you don't forget. There are times, you know, I'll forget and the Holy Spirit will remind me. I've got it on mirrors. When I put my makeup on, I've got it in the bathroom, I've got it in the front door, so I'll make sure I will not leave the house without putting that full armor. Do not go to work. Don't go anywhere, to the grocery store. Do not go nowhere, saints, because our world's about to change, and we need God's protection as we go out the door. You know, I love Psalm 91, Psalm 23, Psalm 40, was it 42 or 46? It might be both of them. 46, I believe it is. You know, I love to read God's word. I love the Psalms. All right, so put the full armor. Now, I'm going to read you some news here. Did you see this? This was in Florida. The governor, do you remember he ran against that Santos guy? Did you hear about this? Man busted with Andrew Gillum in a hotel room with meth was gay escort. Did you hear about that? You can pull that up. He was caught in a room with more than just drugs. This was that man that ran against DeSantos in Florida for governor. I mean, this is what we're going to put in office, saints. Can you believe this? We need to pray. We want to make sure that God puts in office those that He's calling in these last days. Because this is what we're seeing. All right. I want to talk to you a little about this coronavirus. Now, I pulled up this one I'm not going to tell you where, because I don't want no strikes. I've been getting strikes on my account. President Donald Trump, did you hear they're pulling down his Facebook ads? All right. They don't want truth. I mean, they've been coming at me for videos I had up talking about Islam when President Obama was in office. All right. They pulled them down. They were causing me strikes. I was trying to close up my YouTube, and but then if I do that, you won't be able to see it, so I don't want to do that. All right. Did you hear about this? America's hospitals brace for a coronavirus collapse. Doctors fear the system will buckle as cases spike, and experts predict 500,000 is what they're saying, are already infected, and 10 million will need medical care, they're saying. This is what they're saying. Okay, well, we know that the news wants to cause fear. All right, you heard what President Trump said. What, 50 that died? I mean, people die all the time from influenza and the flu. All right. But I want to share this with you because I felt this was God. What a mighty God we serve, saints. You and I don't have to be afraid. You know, this morning I was
thinking about, you know, I was just thinking about, you know, because everyone is panicking, they're worried, they're running to the store, getting their sanitizer, getting their mask. And, you know, I'm thinking, well, Lord, how are you going to keep us protected and safe? You know, God is so good. You know, first I want to tell you this. Daniel said this to me, okay? But I don't agree with this, okay? I don't agree all the way with what he's saying. Because we're not going to live in fear, okay? God is getting ready to bring us out into the lion's den. And more of you are going to come too, okay? Remember, I've talked about, I'm doing a book, The Men and Women in Caves. We can't die in our cave, saints. We can't live in fear, afraid that we're going to catch something if we go out. Remember, I told you I would go into hospitals. I would forget to put the gown on, forget to put the mask on. I would just go in there and do what God's called me to do. I was called to pray. I was telling Daniel about that today. You know, I was starting to see God move when I was volunteering in the hospital because, you know, I'm bold. And this lady, she was a Christian. And I would go like this because she was starting to hear. I would go like this, can you hear, you know? And this was a... She was related to, at the time, a pastor's church that I was going to. Remember, I talked about that. And she was starting to hear. Well, then this nurse says to me, she goes, what are you doing? And they told somebody, and I ended up getting kicked out. I think I've been in 2 or 3 hospitals. And so I don't go to hospitals anymore. I don't go anywhere. I'm waiting on the Lord. And so, how did I get on that? Anyways, so... You know, I was saying I'd go to these hospitals and I would forget to put the gown on. And there were times I would stretch my hands. Remember, who was that? Was it Paul? The handkerchief or whatever? I would stretch my hands and I would pray for them while they were in their beds. Okay, I didn't walk over to the lawn because some of them had this tape on the door. You weren't allowed to go in the room. And then others, I was allowed to go, but I was supposed to put the gown on and wear a mask. And I would literally just go in and I would forget to put the gown and mask on. I didn't do it on purpose, but God protected me, you know. And I believe we're to use etiquette and we're supposed to wash our hands and do those things. Yes, I'm not telling you don't do that, okay? So, I believe we're... But we can't walk around in fear thinking, oh, God, I'm going to catch this disease. You know, God. You know, he showed me. Ow! Sorry, I have to praise God because we serve a mighty God. You hear me? We serve a mighty God. Say, you don't need to live in fear. God will protect you and me if we will walk in his ways. Hallelujah. I got to share this. Daniel was telling me in the quarantine back in the Old Testament, okay, I'm not going to read all the scriptures to you. Well, we know there were those that had leprosy and they were living in sin, okay, and they were stuck and had to be quarantined and they were away from the rest of the camp, right? Well, God showed me this, and I thought this was neat. This was what he had said to me. This is good. Exodus, because he showed me this. Exodus 12, 23 through 27. I'm going to read it from the easy to read version. Exodus 12, 23 through 27. At the time the Lord goes through Egypt, remember when he killed the firstborn, he will see the blood on top of the sides and top of each door frame. Then he will protect that house and not let the destroyer come into your houses and hurt you. You must remember this command. Okay, I'm not going to read all of it, but you know what God was showing me? I get so excited. You and I are born again. We know the Lord, right? So we have been washed in the blood of the Lamb. We've been born again. You know, you can read this. I'm not going to read all of this here. I'm praying out. Remember in Hebrews 9, 23, 10 through 18, it talks about Jesus Christ, the only sacrifice we need. Remember in old days, they had to do their sacrifices. Well, Jesus was our one and only sacrifice. So he was showing me, if we have been born again and we're walking with the Lord, guess what? He's going to skip over us. We don't need to worry. He's got your back. He's got your back and my back. You know, what? You ever wonder why some people go home and others don't? That's because... You know, God knows our time. Remember, I've talked about, you know, the day you're going to be born and the day you're going home. So God's in control, saints. You and I don't need to worry. You know, because I started thinking about this morning. I was like, God, how am I going to go on to Alliance and what? How are you going to protect me? But he's going to skip over me and you. If you will walk with the Lord, you'll get in that prayer closet. You'll pray and seek the Lord. Don't walk in fear, but walk with the Lord every day of your life. Not sometimes. That don't mean get open your Bible sometimes and read it sometimes. No. Every single day you spend time with God. All right. No, we're not under laws. We're not under how much time we spend, you know, how many scriptures I'm reading. We're not under that religion. No. We're free. Whom the Son sets free is free indeed. I mean, there are times I don't have time to do what I should do. And I pray I don't get so busy that I don't put Jesus first. He's my everything. He needs to be your everything. You need to put Jesus first in your life. Yes, I'm home right now, but I'm going to get busy. I'm not going to be here. But I never want to forget the Lord. I always want to keep Jesus first. Because when we keep Jesus at the top, everything else comes in order. Do you hear me, saints? When Jesus is first in our lives, everything comes in order. But what happens is we get so out of order. We get so busy going here, going there, doing this, doing that, taking care of our family, going to work, doing all these things that we don't have time for God. You know, God wants you and I to be Mary's, sitting at the Lord's feet, not being Martha's busy going here, going there. You know, even pastors. Hey, I'm talking to you too. We can be so busy thinking, well, that's a great thing. And it may be a good thing, but it's not the best thing. You need to be spending quality time with God so that you know what to say to your congregation. You want to hear the voice clear. All of us do. I want to hear. You know, I don't say everything correctly. I'm not too proud that I say I miss God. We all need to hear from God in these last days. So, Father, open up our ears and our hearts to hear and receive what it is you're wanting to say to us, Lord. Help us to make time for you and not get so busy doing everything that the world is wanting us to do. Distractions, chaos, things that are getting ready to happen, Lord, that we keep our focus on you today. In Jesus' name, amen, amen. And we need to pray for President Donald Trump, you know, because he is the head. We need to pray that he turn back to God and that we repent as a nation and that he'll be led by God. You know, because he's got a big job on his hands. You know, whether you voted for him or not, whether you voted for President Trump, you like him or not, okay? You may say things that he shouldn't say. I say things, you say things, okay? But he's fighting for the American people. He's looking out for us. We need to pray that he has an encounter with God. Because he could be, like I said before, he could be a baby Christian. It's not your place to judge him, and it's not my place. But it is our place to pray for our leaders. Pray for those that are over us. Your governor, your mayor, your police officer, your boss, okay? Wives, your husband. We're to pray for them. Ask God to change their heart so that they do what is right. So, Father, we pray for President Donald Trump. We stop right now and we pray for our president, Lord. We love him, Lord. We, the Christians, lift him up, Lord. We pray for a hedge of protection over him right now from the top of his head to the soles of his feet. He looked like he was tired, Lord. Lord, we just pray right now that you protect him and keep him safe from this coronavirus, Lord, him and Vice President Mike Pence and all those that are working in the administration and doing that are surrounding him right now, Lord. Send your angels round about him. Keep him safe and protected, Lord. He's fighting for the American people. He's doing what you're calling him to do. But we believe, Lord, that he's going to have an encounter with you. And he's going to humble this nation to where we seek you, Lord. And do what is right, Lord, in our nation. Yes, we're going to be living amongst the tares. The wheat and tares are going to grow together, Lord. And we're not serving President Donald Trump, but you placed him in office for such a time as this. I truly believe there's going to be one last move of your spirit touching our nation, a revival, Lord. We're going to see in our nation families, those that don't know you, Lord, that now is the time they're going to give their hearts and lives to you, Lord. We believe that right now, Jesus. So we pray, Father, for a mighty move, Lord, of your spirit, Lord, to touch this nation, touch this world, Lord, a revival, Lord, in this whole entire world, we're believing that a shaking is coming. We don't need to be afraid. We don't need to worry because, Lord, you are in control, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you because the best days are ahead of us, Lord. You said no eye has seen, no ear has heard what you have prepared for those that love you. Lord, we love you. We praise you, Lord. We exalt you, Lord. We believe the best days are ahead of us. And you're getting ready to send your people out there to do the work that you've called us to do in these last days. And we just give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen, amen. It's coming, saints. You know, I'm going to share something with you really quick. You know, I'm not here to bash anyone. But I've said something before about this. And I've told you before, you can read Elijah lists. Okay, they have some prophetic words that the Holy Spirit is speaking through the people. But there are others that I don't agree with, okay? But I'm going to say something about this, and I normally wouldn't. And there'll be people that'll talk bad about me, but I'm not talking bad about this person. I'm not bashing them. I don't know their heart, only God does. But I am going to say something, all right? This gentleman, this was 2 years, we're talking over 2 years ago. I mentioned it on here, but I also want to talk about these words in a minute. I sent an email because the Holy Spirit had led me. This was over 2 years ago. Let me see if I can find it. By a gentleman, I don't know if you've heard of him, Johnny Enloe. And I have nothing against him. Johnny, if you're listening to me, I want you to know God loves you. And we love you in the Lord. I have nothing against you. But at that time, when I had sent him an email, he said to me, he doesn't take time to answer people like me. He said, I do not believe your prophetic warnings, is what he said. And the word, and your words are from the Lord, is what he said. I was specifically sent to move to California because at that time he was living in California. This was November 14th, 2017. And part of my stated assignment is to cast down words of judgment, he said, that comes against California, he said. All right. And I'm not going to go on it. And then I referred to David Wilkerson. And he said that's a bad reference point. So he didn't agree with David Wilkerson. More than 40 years have passed on prophetic words he gave, and even he came to know he was wrong about them, which I don't believe that, because now we're starting to see some of David Wilkerson's stuff. My dad was telling me, you can't even buy some of his books, okay? So I believe the Holy Spirit was speaking to David Wilkerson. You know, nobody's perfect, okay? So we got to quit judging these prophets and the timing, too. You know, that's why I love that scripture. One day is like 1,000 years, 1,000 years are like one day. The Holy Spirit gave that to me. Because it hasn't even been one day in the Lord's eyes yet. It has to be 1,000 years. So when people say, oh, that's not from God, you know, I'm just learning to overlook it, you know, and not even answer and just, you know, I'm not there yet, but I'm trying just to ignore people. Because, you know what, God does not want us to fight with them and try to prove our point. Because what happens is then they'll come back and they'll fight with you. We just gotta love them. Let them go. Alright. So he was telling me he didn't believe. Well, I just want to share this with you because now he's in Nashville. So I'm thinking, well, Lord, if I was so false, why did he move out of California? Why is he now living in Nashville? He moved. Alright. And that's all I want to say. You know, and I have nothing bad against him. But you know, we are now seeing what the true prophetic servants have been saying all along, okay? And it's not a gloom and doom message, and it's not to be me. It's because God, that's what a prophetic servant is to do. We're to warn. If we see something coming, we're to warn and let you know. He'll show the prophetic servants first before he shows the world, all right? But when you get time, take a look at some of these. I'm not going to go through them all the time. Elijah Les has some on there speaking that are not from the Lord. I mean, I'm just going to tell you right now. This one I spoke the other day said, and then they're using, this one was talking about this virus being the enemy. Let me tell you something. God allows things. It's not always the enemy, all right? We can't blame everything on the devil, all right? sometimes it's our own. You know, we're living in sin. America has not yet repented, okay? I told you, Daniel studies a lot about the New World Order and the cult and what America has got into, all right? We are steeped in the occult. We've got these idols throughout the nation, all right? Just standing up. We worship, I mean, the things, we worship all gods here in America. There's only one true God, and his name is Jesus Christ. These other gods can't do miracles, cannot help us, okay? Remember, we've talked about Elijah, all right? These other gods, we as a nation cannot look to us to because they're not going to help us, all right? The only God we can look to is Jesus. They're false gods. All right, well, somebody was talking about blaming this whole thing on the enemy, all right, and that this is why this is happening. Well, you know, let me tell you something. People are going to do what they want to do, and they don't want to hear truth, all right? They want to kill millions of babies. They want to sleep around. They want to have their transgender and same-sex marriage. They want what they want. So God's going to send leans on your soul. He's going to stand back and say, okay, you want to do what you want to do? I'm just going to let you. So it's not all the enemy. We as a nation have to repent. You know, God judged Israel, right? He judged those in old days. He's going to judge our nation. And it's not to be mean. It's the truth. If we do not do what is right, God's going to judge us. I mean, you're seeing it. It's getting, I mean, it's going quickly. It's getting worse. I mean, it was not like this years ago, right? You know, I mean, you're seeing things are changing very quick. Some people say, oh, it's been like, no, things have, that's because they're blinded. They're blinded and they're sleeping. And I hate to say this, but there's a lot of Christians that are not even awake. They're in their own little world. Everybody's so busy going here and going there. All right. So I want to talk about a little bit about this coronavirus. All right. I don't know if you saw this article. Brawls break out at Costco, Sam's Club, and coronavirus. People are, you know, they were going, yesterday when I went, you know, they had these gloves, you know, gloves. They had their sanitizer cart. Well, and of course the toilet paper. We can't forget the toilet paper. All right. In fact, they got tons of toilet paper. And the mask, you know, I had these from when I was cleaning the house. I had those masks. You know, they get all the, and hey, I'm going to tell you right now, none of that's going to protect us. We've got to look to the Lord. You can have all that stuff. We can panic, get worried. We can have all that stuff, but it's not going to help us, saints. We've got to look to the Lord. All right. I don't know about you, but I know I've been getting a lot of emails from different places, how they're preparing and getting ready, you know. And I just want to say, if, you know, we're so used to, people are so used to going places. See, Daniel and I don't go anywhere. I've talked about this before. We just sit here. So this is not new for us, all right? It's going to be harder for you and for other people that are so used to going places. We've seen now sports closing down, and it's not safe to go anywhere to even to let others touch your food or go into the malls, you know, because for one, we're not talking about food. We're not going to talk about this right now, but we have to be careful with the food because they've got pesticides, additives. That's why you need to be praying over your food, giving God thanks, and also praying that God will protect, sanctify it because the food is not safe anymore. We're seeing locusts after we've talked about the weather patterns and how our food and what's happening and we've talked about these earthquakes and how they're spreading out and they're coming more and more. If you look at those five dangerous fault lines, we've talked about that. Okay, what if they all just, the ring of fire? Volcanoes are waking up, the dead fish, the dead birds. I mean, this has been going on for a while. I mean, it's going to reach a point and we're going to see a change. It's coming, saints, and there's nothing you and I can do to stop it. We see how they're wanting to shoot down these asteroids, and we've heard about that before. You know, the asteroids are passing by, and the Bible talks about it, that there's going to be an asteroid. There's nowhere for us to hide in a cave or under a rock, and NASA's telling us we need to leave the planet. Where are we going to go? The only place that we can go is hide in the presence of the Lord. Get alone with God. Maybe we should read this. I'm going to go with the Bible. know, I just, you know, I want to be loved by the Lord, and this is what he's telling me. We don't need to be afraid, saints. If you got a Bible, let's read it. Psalm 91. Okay. This is what we need to do. Dwell in the presence of the Lord. He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. See, we don't need to live in fear. We don't need to live in fear, saints. But we've got to look to the Lord. Surely he will save you from the fowler's snare and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with his feathers, and under his wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness will be your shield and rampart. You will not fear the terror of night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that stalks in the darkness, nor the plague that destroys at midday. 1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you. You will only observe with your eyes, see the punishment of the wicked. If you make the Most High your dwelling, see, you've got to make the Most High your dwelling. You've got to put him first, saints. Even the Lord who is my refuge. Then no harm will befall you, no disaster will come near your tent. If you don't know the Lord, you've never called him, today's your day. What are you waiting for? What are you waiting for? We're running out of time. I'm talking to some of you that listen to me. And then you put my video down. You know the Holy Spirit is speaking to you, but you refuse to believe. You've got to see something first. What's faith? Faith is some of the things hoped for, yet not seen. You're seeing the world's changing, all right? What more do you have to see? God's trying to get your attention. You're going to wait till you're on your deathbed. There's going to be those. It's going to be too late. I'm talking to you. There's going to be some that are going to go like that. You will not have time to cry to the Lord and repent. Do it now. I'm talking to some of you. Do it now. Go to God. Bow your head and just say, Jesus, I'm a sinner. Forgive me of my sins. Cleanse me and wash me in your blood. Come into my heart and save me, Jesus. I need you now. I see the world falling apart, Lord. Save me, Lord. In Jesus, just go to God. That's all you got to do. But stop waiting. Stop waiting for something big to happen. Because I'm going to tell you right now, there's going to be those that are going to die like that. There are going to be those that are going to die without a second chance to receive the Lord. There are people right now in hell burning. Do you want to go to hell? God's talking to you. Stop being stubborn. There are those that are stubborn and won't hear anything I've got to say. All right? They have made up their mind that they're not going to listen. Well, you know what? My heart goes out to you. My heart goes out to you, and I pray for you. I pray that you'll have a change of heart and that you'll call the Lord now. Because there are people that have already died and they're there. Don't go there. Don't go there. And it doesn't matter what I say. You know, for those that don't know, I was in a dangerous car accident. I almost died. I should have been dead. I was on my way to church when a drunk driver hit me. I had brain surgery. My hair is growing out. You never even know. I'm a walking miracle. It's because Jesus. I was born again, but I wanted to do my life over again. I was in this coma for 3 weeks. I wasn't dead. But I remember I want to do my life over again. I was born again. But I want to tell you, there's no such thing as reincarnation. Once you're dead, you're dead. You cannot come back and be something else. If you don't know Christ today, I'm pleading with you. Call on him now. You will not get a second chance. You're going to die suddenly. There are those that are going to die suddenly, and that's going to be it. And then there will be those, I've said this before, they're backslidden. You're going to go home early. And then you're going to wish that there were things that you should have done. I'm talking to you. Jesus loves you. Just go to God and say, God, forgive me. I haven't been doing what you want me to do. But today, Lord, today I make the first step. Whenever it's time for me to go home, just go to God. He hears you. We don't have to live our life in fear. You know, there's going to be disasters everywhere. Could be right here where I live in Florida. But you know what? I'm not going to live in fear. My hope and trust is in God. And I said this to the Lord. I said, God, I love you, Lord. And I'm not going to worry about this coronavirus, because when it's time for me to go home, I've done everything that you wanted me to do. Don't you want him to say, well done, my good and faithful son and daughter, that you did what he asked you to do? I'm going to tell you right now, going here, going there, planning your own life, doesn't matter. Once you're dead, you're dead. You want to make sure you're doing God's will. I want to make sure I've done God's will. No, I'm not perfect. I have my sins. But I love the Lord with all my heart. And I want to do his will. If you want to do his will, he sees your heart. Maybe, you know, you're struggling with issues. God knows. None of us are perfect. The only one that's perfect is Jesus. So we've got to keep pressing on and doing what he's called us to do. Remember, Paul, he talked about, why do I do those things that I shouldn't be doing? That I keep doing. But see, if your heart is right and you're not willfully just doing whatever you feel like doing, God sees your heart and my heart. He sees that you want to do what's right, and God will help you. All right? Yes, there's an enemy out there. He wants to come at you and me. We got to resist the devil. And God will not give us more than we can handle. All right? So we've got to keep our focus on you. He will help you and I. All right? He's coming back for a bride without spot or wrinkle. He wants to get you and I ready for what's ahead. I just felt led to say that. Let me go back to Psalm 91. Verse 9, if you make the Most High your dwelling, even the Lord is my refuge, then no harm will befall you, no disaster will come near your tent. For he will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. Amen? They will lift you up in their hands so that you will not strike your foot against a stone. You will tread upon the lion and the cobra. Amen? You will trample the great lion and the serpent. Verse 14, because he loves me, says the Lord, I will rescue him. See, God will rescue you and I. Because you love him. I will protect him from, he acknowledges my name. You know, when I've got a problem, you know where I go? I get on my knees. I cry out to God. I don't get on the phone, start calling everyone. Get on your knees. Get in your prayer closet and call on the name of the Lord. God will protect you. He will call upon me and I will answer him. I'll be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation. See, if we will just go to God, saints, Jesus is our answer. He's our nation's answer. When we don't know what to do, we go to God. God has the answer. I don't have the answer. Did you see that video where I was talking to President Trump? We need to go to God. I want to help because I've sent letters in the mail. And I said, I want to be, you know how he has these women entrepreneurs? I said, I want to be a woman prophetess. You know, I've talked to John L. Casey. God woke me up. I said, like, almost 2 or 3 years ago, I said, move away from the West Coast. And I've been sending stuff ever since. I put it on the White House. I put it now on his Twitter page. I don't know if he sees it. I put it there. I put it, some people that are part of his prayer team. Vice President Mike Pence's secretary, because I'm doing my job. God wants me to warn. That's what I'm called to do. I had one lady say, well, why are you, you know, and she was attacking me, and I just need to leave her alone and just smile and love her, you know, because yes, there's going to be people that are going to attack you and I in these last days. They do it on the front when I'm out there warning people. You know, they're going to grit their teeth. They're not going to want to hear it. So I told you about this, right? Facebook, they're removing Trump ads. See, they want to take your freedom, my freedoms away. Okay, but they're not going to be able to stop it. I'm going to tell you right now. God's going to do something they can't do. Anything. Look at this virus. It's going to get to a point. They can't do anything. We're going to have to go to God. This is what's going to usher a revival. You see what I'm saying? We're going to be praying. Because man can't do anything, we're going to have to pray. And we're not just going to have this coronavirus. We're going to have many disasters. We're not going to know what to do. We're going to have to go to God. We're going to have to pray, saints. We've been saying that. But it's like we wait. We see how much we can get away with until we finally come to God. We're all like that. Stubborn, you know, just like a kid. Remember we've talked about it. God's going to discipline the body of Christ. He's coming back for a bride without a spot or wrinkle, and we're going to see him. He's already starting. All right, I'm not going to talk about all this news because I don't feel led to. I don't get into news, all that news. I just know enough to tell you. Remember, now President Trump started these travel bans with Europe. Remember, I've talked about it. America going into lockdown. You heard him today. He said they're working with other states. So are they going to lock down other states? And we're going to be where we can't go anywhere. This is all part of the New World Order. I'm telling you, we're getting ready to see a change. Remember that word about fear is about to grip the American people. All right. I'm not going to go through all these words. For those that are subscribers on our YouTube can listen to them. You can also, there's another website that just has prophetic words. You can go on there. I'm not going to do all that now. I do want to talk about this, though. Let me see. I got all this paperwork. See, I want to be led by the Lord. I don't want to just talk about what I want to talk about. I told you this on the internet. They're talking about this coronavirus. The internet is saying it's fake news. And they're calling it a conspiracy theory about the Chinese biological weapon. All right. They don't want you and I knowing, okay? We can't trust these other nations. We can't trust China, Russia, North Korea, Iran, all right? The only one we can trust is God. We can't trust any of them. And we've got to pray for Israel. We don't need to be dividing Israel with Israel's enemies and armies. They don't like America. They say death to Israel, death to America. So why are we wanting to give them a capital in Israel and share an embassy? They want President Trump's head. I mean, come on. Why aren't the prayer warriors warning? Say, hey, let's not go there. Don't go there. That's trouble. All right. Now, did you hear about this? China hints at denying Americans life-saving coronavirus drugs. Okay. See, I told you back in July last year, America's going to have a crisis. Remember when Daniel was having all those problems? And God, I was like, God, where are you? You know, because I never did this. I never was where I was pacing up and down praying in the spirit. I was like, God, where are you? And I felt like a demonic spirit was hovering over us. And I would go to the hospital and cry. I had no one that would really pray with me. And it was very hard. It was very difficult because I remember every day getting up, crying to the Lord. I'm like, God, I can't deal with this. You know, and I made Daniel stay in the bed. Don't get up. Don't get up, you know. And that's when I heard God say to me, I'm teaching you how to handle a crisis situation because we're going to go through this. And I believe we're going to go through it. People are going to panic, anxiety. You know, Daniel has been slowly healing from this anxiety. And I try to keep him calm because when I would try to go get him those drugs, you know, I forget that one, Emian or something he likes. But when I would go get it, they had certain things they didn't have. And I would only give it to him at certain times. So I would tell him, only take it if you need it. All right. And because the Holy Spirit is showing me this. That's why I'm not telling you to do that. Some of you are diabetic, whatever. Take your medication. Do whatever God is telling you to do and do it right now. If your healing's not here, you just do what you're supposed to do. Okay, Daniel was okay. Daniel told me there were times God didn't want him to go to the hospital, but he was panicking. And so, because there were times I said, I'm not going with you, you're on your own, you know. And the ambulance people, they got tired of coming back with the ambulance. They're like, here we go again, you know. So Daniel was just where he didn't want to deal with it anymore. In fact, like I told you, they the first time they drove him way, I forget, in Orlando, away from me, I didn't even know where he was. Nobody told me nothing. His family didn't tell me. God bless them. I pray for them, love them in the Lord. They didn't tell me nothing. Nobody told me. God told me. You know what's so awesome? God, you know, God saw me crying. I was crying. And Daniel couldn't think straight. Twice I was crying and he picked up the phone and called me. That was God. God knew what I was going through. He picked the phone up and called me. And I said, what am I, God, we serve? Isn't he awesome? God is good. He knows what he's doing. All right, so we're here now also, I was going to talk about that President Donald Trump just got his testing done. What we already prayed for, we pray for his protection, that God will keep him safe. Let me share this word with you really quick here. Okay. Like I said, I'm not going to go through all the words. I've given the word about a massive earthquake coming to the United States back in May of last year. America's kind of a crisis situation. In July, I had that. Two or three years ago, I said, move away from the West Coast. I've given tons of prophetic words. The Holy Spirit's given, not just me, but other prophetic servants. That's why you need to pray on that, what is the Holy Spirit saying to you. All right. I believe we're getting ready to get out of this cave. I don't know where I'm going. God has not literally told me yet, but I do know, not just for me, you as well, we cannot be distracted. We got to focus on the Lord because so that we can hear what the Holy Spirit is saying to us in these last days. Just the other day, 3/13/20, I heard, I was reading about, and I normally don't, like I said, I don't look at the news because I don't want any of my words to be influenced by the news. There are times God will tell me something about Israel. I'm like, I don't know a lot about prophecy. The Holy Spirit's teaching me. You know, he's teaching all of us. We don't know everything. And so I was reading about the spread of this coronavirus, you know. And out of nowhere, I mean, I heard this out of nowhere. Okay. I heard him say, the Holy Spirit say, the coronavirus will die off. Then there will come another virus. Now, you need to pray about this and see what God's saying to you. A lady had talked about this. Yeah, I'm going to read it afterward here. All right. And I'm just going to read this to you. This is what that I was getting. This virus that will come, I'm sensing in my spirit, will be more deadly than the coronavirus. You know how the coronavirus is like the flu, and the majority of the patients recover from it after being quarantined for 14 days. This virus that is coming, and I don't know when it's coming, I don't know, is it the plagues in Revelation 15, 16? I hope we're not here. Okay, but this is what it gave me. This virus that is coming will kill people right on the spot, is what he was telling me. There will be no cure for it, he was showing me. I'm sensing in my spirit, and you will not be able to prevent it from getting worse. I don't know if you heard President Donald Trump say it yesterday. He said, hopefully we'll be ready for what's coming next. Because he said something about worse. Like, it's like he knew something was coming. You know, I'm wondering if the Holy Spirit, you know, if he's reading these other prophetic words or, you know, and, you know, or he's seeing, you know, Mike Pence is a Christian too. So we need to pray for them that God will open their eyes. All right. So God was showing me there's going to be a worse one. He said, you will die instantly. That this virus will be very serious and will be costly. It will cost the lives of many human beings. If you don't know the Lord, then I leave him a prayer. Call upon his name today. Say, Lord Jesus, save me. I need you. Our world is changing. I need you to protect me and keep me safe. In you, I pray in Jesus' name. Then I heard that this virus, and I didn't know anything about this, so I looked it up. I heard him say, that's why I say pray about it. I heard him say, like leukemia, but the difference, let me finish reading this. It will happen suddenly. The difference with leukemia and this new virus is there will be no cure. And I didn't really understand all this, so I want to read you a little bit about leukemia. Okay, there is a cure for leukemia. But with this virus, there will be no cure. And I looked up leukemia. Leukemia is cancer of the white blood cells. White blood cells help your body fight infection. Your blood cells form in your bone marrow. In leukemia, the bone marrow produces abnormal white blood cells. These cells crowd out the healthy blood cells, making it hard for blood to do its work. Leukemia starts in the soft inner part of the bones, bone marrow, but often moves quickly into the blood. It can then spread to other parts of the body, such as the lymph nodes, spleen, liver, and central nervous system, and other organs. We don't need to be afraid, saints. Like I said, remember what the Lord told me? If we're walking with the Lord, it's going to skip over us. All right, so we don't need to be afraid. There are going to be a lot of things that are going to happen. So we got to trust the Lord. Here's a verse I'm going to read you from the Passion Translation, Matthew 24, 6, 8. You'll hear of wars nearby and revolutions on every side, with more rumors of wars to come. Don't panic or give in to your fears. See, can't act out of our emotion. You got to trust the Lord. For the breaking apart of our world system is destined to happen. But it won't yet be the end. It will still be unfolding. See, God warned us. He said this is only the beginning, saints. We don't need to be packing up thinking we're going home. That's why I believe this is my own opinion. Somewhere in the middle of tribulation, the 7 years. Okay? But I do believe God will get you and I out of here. Remember, He took Abraham out of Sodom and Gomorrah. Why would He leave us here? We can't be like Lot's wife and turn around. We're living in a modern day Sodom and Gomorrah. And it's getting bad, worse every single minute, hour. I mean, it's going to get really, really bad. But we can't be living in fear. We got to trust the Lord, you know. And we've got to be willing to change along with what's getting ready to happen. Because if not, we're going to be left behind. We're going to miss what God's going to do. We're not even going to know what's going on. Lord, help us. I pray for me too. You know, He's making me a leader. And I said, God, help me. I don't know if I can do this, Lord. This calling on my life is getting bigger all the time. I'm like, God, I don't know if I can do it. We have to trust God. We just take each day as it comes. All right. Verse 7, nations will go to war against each other and kingdom against kingdom. And there'll be a terrible earthquake, seismic events of epic proportion, horrible epidemics. See, we're going to see a lot of things. So we could see something that may not be the end one, but we could see a really bad plague. And famines in places after place. This is how the first contractions and birth pains of the new age will begin. And that was from the Passion Translation. Sometimes I like to read them out of different versions because it's easier for you and I to understand. Let me read you now this lady. I got her off of Prophecy News. And I looked this up. I saw what she said. Melissa Hall, she gave this word, I believe. Let me see. She said, more virus ahead. This is only a trial run, she had said. I saw this afterward because I wanted to know if anyone else said anything like this. And if God said something to you, let me know. Put your comment down. She received this on 3/11. She says, many are in fear of the coronavirus, my child. They put their trust in man instead of me. Can I protect you? Would I protect you? The answer to both of these questions is yes. The ones who are mine are protected. And I believe that, saints. You and I are protected. I'll protect my children and their children's children up into the third generation. I'll even protect your cousins and your aunts and uncles, your parents and your grandparents. You know, I said to Daniel, I know his birthday's coming up. And I'm like, I didn't want to be around his mom. But, you know, I've got to trust that God, you know what's going to happen. We have to trust God. We can't avoid our families because we're going to get this virus. No, we got to trust our families. Each must come to me to see who is protected and who is not. The conversation is me and you, my little ones. I know you are scared. I know many are rushing out for provisions in case they are held up in their homes. If I ask you to do this, then good. But if I haven't, then I ask you, why have you not come to me with these questions and this fear that has overtaken you? See, that's why I said we can't be led by our emotions, our feelings, things that will come at us. And what everyone else is doing, and we run into the store and do it. We've got to be led by the Holy Ghost. Are you afraid that you won't like the answer? Are you afraid that somehow this virus is too big for me to handle or that I simply won't protect you? I ask you today, my children, is your trust in man or me? Is your trust in stocking up on all these supplies or me? See, our trust is not in the supplies. Our trust better be in the Lord. Is your trust in the news and the media or me? Who are you trusting? Some of you that are trusting in your president, well, he's only a man. He can't solve America's problems. We can pray for him, for his protection, that God would open his eyes, him and all the people that work around him. But right now, we are spiritual. We're fighting not people, but wickedness in high places. So the wheat tares are going to grow together until God gets you and I out of here. Is your trust in the news and media or me? I know it's scary, my little ones. The enemy loves to bring fear to my children, but I am a big, big God. Amen. And I promise to take care of you. I will not let anyone or anything harm you. Amen. Praise God. I will lead you through the wilderness just as I did my Israelites. I'll feed you with a manna from heaven and give you water from the streams to drink. Don't you think I could take care of one jug of water? I said this before, and turn it into 20. That's why I told you, you don't need to rush and get a bunch of stuff. I've seen people digging holes. What for? We will just be led by the Holy Spirit. Remember, there's one. They went and got their food for the day. So you have a little bit of water, a little bit of food, and watch God multiply. Jesus said it, remember? Had them all sit down. So if he did for them, why wouldn't he do it for us? We don't need to worry. We don't need to go to these sites and buy hundreds of dollars, put it on a credit card, and go in debt. Live in fear. I don't have a garden growing back in my apartment. I'm not going to say it. I'm not going to say it. Yeah, I have some canned goods for a rainy day. We all should have something on hand. Okay, but I'm not going to live my life in fear. I know God's in control. But you know what happens is, panic, then what happens? We panic. We all do. I do too, because we're watching everybody. So, but then we got to quiet ourselves before the Lord and stay calm. We got to stay calm, saints. She says, don't you think I could take your one jug of water and turn it into 20? What about the loaves of bread you have, or even your rice and your beans? Don't you think I could multiply that to keep feeding your household and more? Amen. Remember that Elijah, that one lady, she was running out of oil or something, and God used Elijah, she had just enough. So God knows how he takes care of you. There have been times I've been in grocery stores and I have just enough money to pay for whatever I'm buying. God's good. We got to trust the Lord, saints. These times are trying, my children. It all depends upon your faith in me and what you believe I can do. Will you trust me with your lives and even the lives of your little ones? If you give them to me, if you entrust these to me, then I promise to take care of you and them. I will not fail you. I do not disappoint. So I ask you today to let down that fear. It's not yours, was not sent by me. It was sent by the enemy to cause discord and to divide. See, you know, there's something else here. Hold on. I wanted to say something. Let me see what she said. Something. Okay. God was showing me, you know, God, he may not move on your schedule, your time, may not do things the way you want it done. Okay. But he'll do it. Remember what Paul said, if he provides food, clothing, we shall be content. So God will always meet our needs. May not always meet our wants. We have been spoiled. I'm letting you know, including me. We in America, you know, we are afraid we can go buy whatever we want, do whatever we want. But a time's coming where we're not going to be able to do that, saints. We're going to have to put our trust in God to provide for us. We're not going to be able to just run to the store or go buy this or go buy that. You know, you're seeing things on the shelves are going to run out. They're not going to be there. So we have to trust God to take care of us. And I don't like that. I'm going to be honest. No, we're so used to having everything. We in America are spoiled. You know, we live in this fantasy world where, you know, we don't realize what we have. All right. The people, the rich and famous people, you know, they think everything is owed to them, you know. But you little guys like me, you know, have to, you know, I don't work, thank God he provides for me. But, you know, you have to go to work and you have to trust God to take care of you. And he will, you know. But we can't go around worrying, you know, because we're going to go through things. We have to trust God that he's going to take care of us. So, I'm not going to read any more of this, I don't think. But she was saying it's all propaganda, my children. Many players in play here, and you are the puppets on the string. See, the enemy wants to work you. He wants you to get fearful. It's a tactic. Remember, I said a tactic from the enemy. Don't let anyone else be the puppeteer and take control of you but me. Don't let anyone else lead you but me. And that's what's happening. You're seeing these people rush to the stores. They're panicking. The enemy is causing fear, all right? Don't listen to anyone else but me, for I see the whole picture. I know what is being hidden behind the scenes. And above all, I know what is best for my children. And see, that's why I told you, we've got to obey the leaders over. See, God knows. God knew all this was going to happen, saints. We're the ones that get fearful and we worry because we're not spending time with God. We're not being led by His Holy Spirit. We're just going here, going there, doing our own thing. Okay, now is the time to get in your prayer closet and seek the Lord. Let Him direct you, God. Let Him take control over your life. Stop trying to control your life for yourselves, all right? Because I'm going to tell you right now, God's going to have His way. He's going to have your way with you, with me, in the church, and in the world. All right, He's going to humble America. He's going to humble the world. We're getting ready to see that. That is getting ready to happen. I'm not trying to draw fear, but I'm trying to tell you what we're getting ready to see. And let's pray for all of us because, you know, I can't be on there 24/7. I want you to know I sometimes feel burdened. You know, I'm up all the time, and it's God. Because I can't do it, saints. I mean, I get tired. And I'm like, God, I need your help. I need your strength. I want to be led by you, Lord. I want to be doing things on my own. Because as the remember, He's speeding up the time. He said in the last days He's going to do it. That's why it's so important that we be led by His Spirit. Lord, should I go here? Should I go there? What is it you want me to do? And we need to say that more every day. Lord, what is it you want me to do today? Lord, what is it you want me to do? Show me, lead me, guide me. And Lord, I pray that for myself. Lord, show me and guide me. Because I don't want to be led by my flesh. I want to be led by His Spirit. You know, even when He gets ready to open doors and open the door and I'm free. No, I'm so used to sitting here. I've been waiting. Daniel and I have been waiting for over 20-something years for this right now. And I'm like, yeah, I get a little nervous because, you know, we're so used to sitting here. And we're getting ready to go out to the lion's den. And I want to make sure we're led by the Lord, and we do what God's asked us to do. That's why I told Daniel, God's got us waiting. We've got to wait on the Lord. He's taught us how to wait. That's why I can't stress it enough, saying, wait on the Lord. Let Jesus open the doors for you. Don't push that door open yourself. Let God lead you. Let Him guide you. He'll show you the way. If He wants you to do something and He don't want you to do it, He'll let you know. And then sometimes you may step out and He'll say, no, I don't want you to do that. And then you come back. All right, so He's teaching all of us, if we'll look to Him and we'll pray to Him, He'll show us where it is He wants you to go. We don't need to worry, saints, all right? I don't know how much longer I'm going to be on this YouTube. I'm going to be somewhere else. I'm waiting on the Lord, and the same goes for you. Don't worry. Don't be fearful. Know that God is in control. Let's pray. Father, I pray for all of us as we get ready to leave, Lord. Father, I pray for a hedge of protection over us, Lord. Our world's about to change, Lord. But we're not going to be fearful, Lord. It's not until it happens, Lord, that we realize it. But, Lord, I ask you to please help us today. We can't do any of this on our own, Lord. We look to you, Lord. Our times are in your hands, Lord. You know the end, the beginning from the end. You know everything, Lord. Father, I pray that for America, that you watch over all of us, Lord. Keep our nation safe, Lord. Keep our presence safe, Lord. Keep them in the palm of your hands, Lord. Direct us and guide us. I pray all of us, Lord, save your people that need salvation. Save our families that don't know you, Lord. Save our friends, acquaintances, people we come across. Lord, bring the backslid back to you, Lord. We just pray that right now in Jesus' name. We know things are getting ready to take place, Lord, but we're not going to be afraid, Lord. Our hope and trust is in you, Lord. We get in our prayer closets. We pray. We seek you, Lord. We ask that you would direct us and guide us each and every day, moment of our lives, Lord. And that would be right with you, Lord. Because things are about to happen, Lord. In Jesus' name, now go with us, each and every one of us, I pray today. Amen, amen. All right, saints. You know, I've given the warnings. I've done what God's asked me to do. And I keep saying, well, we're almost out of here. I keep doing these videos because the Holy Spirit is wanting me to do them. And in fact, I was going to wait. I was going to put it up Monday, but I'm doing it now. This is what I feel led to do. I got to do it now, you know. So, all right, I think that's it. I want you to know we love you, and we're praying for you. If you feel led to help us, we're not going home. And just want to make this, the Holy Spirit just remind me, if you have a lot to help our ministry, whether it's 5, 10, whatever God's telling you to give. All right. If you'd like to plant a seed or you'd like to partner with our ministry, if you would send it to Dawn's Heartfelt Corner, P.O. Box 161273, Altamont Springs, Florida 32716. You can also, you can put it through our PayPal at heartfeltcorner10@gmail.com. We are 501. You can write it at the end of the year. We're not going home yet. You need to be helping out those ministers right now that you see that God is using. We all going to have to help one another in these last days, all right? Stop giving your hard-earned money to those ministries that are just pocketing it. They're not walking with God. They're not praying, asking God, how should I use your money? You want to be helping those ministries that God is speaking to you about. And I personally, Daniel, I say thank you from the bottom of our heart for helping our ministry. We couldn't do this without you. There are those that God has called specifically to help us, and we thank you. And you know who you are, and we thank you. There hasn't been many, but there have been some, and we thank God for your faithful giving. And there's going to be others, because God told me there's going to be others. You know, like I said, you do whatever God's telling you to do, not what I'm telling you to do, what anyone. I'm not about money. God knows I'm not. I'm into Jesus. I love the Lord. Now, if you have a prayer need, you're on deathbed, and you need me to pray for you, put it to my attention. Put Prophetess Dawn O'Brien, and I'll make sure I get my own mail. If you have something you want to send to me, or if anything, you want my attention, not all your prayers, though, okay? If it's dire need and you need prayer or you have something you want to give me, go ahead and put Prophetess Dawn O'Brien. Other than that, it's going to go to the regular mailbox because I'm going to get busier. I'm praying we have more people that will help us. You know, I'm not going to worry. You don't worry, all right? But I'm not like one of those ministries eventually when God uses, I'm going to send out things. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to be led by the Holy Spirit and let Him lead me. And that's what you need to do. You know, it's not about money. It's not. It's about Jesus. All right. I think that's it. Once again, we love you. We're praying for you. Please keep us in prayer. Please pray for me. You know, it's not easy getting up here and speaking, but, you know, I have to do what God's called me to do. This is the calling that God has placed on my life, and I give Jesus all the praise, the honor, and glory. And until we meet again, whether it's in this cave or outside, hopefully it's outside. This is Prophetess Dawn O'Brien, Sermon of the Lord with Dawn's Heartfelt Corner. Have a safe and blessed day and Sunday. And remember to pray. Pray for President Donald Trump. Pray for the nation of America. Get on your knees and pray, saints, wherever you're at. All right, talk to you soon. God bless you.